Hey guys, this is Kristen Vietty with Philadelphia Orchard Project, and we're going to film a little video about natural dyes. Today we're going to use a plant that grows in some of the Philadelphia Orchard Project orchards called Perilla, also known as shiso. I'm really intrigued by its color qualities. The Perilla has some anthocyanins in them, which is the pigment that provides a lot of the like red and purple and blue tones that we see in nature. So like purple cabbage or purple flowers or like the red that you see in fall leaves, berries. So I just think this stuff is pretty weird and interesting, and I don't quite know what color it wants to be. So I figured we'd do a little bit of experiment. I made some Perilla dye at home. So these are the exact same dye, but I wanted to experiment with pH/alkalinity, because I think the anthocyanin pigment is very pH responsive. I've gotten anywhere from a pink to a green to like a steely blue from this pigment. So I'm just really curious to see what it does. So to one, I plan on adding vinegar, which I think will make things more pink. The other batch, I wanted to add soda ash, which I made by baking soda. You can just buy soda ash. I didn't have any on hand, so I had baking soda. So I'm not sure how apparent this will be, but let's just see what happens. Oh, I smell it. So, I really don't know if you can tell on camera, but to me, this did make it redder. I'm going to add some soda ash to this batch. Ooh. So, I don't think you could see that, but when I put it in, you can kind of see it on the side, it like looked green as I was putting it in. Oh wow, look at the bottom. So it's like an olive green. Okay, I suspect that it might make it blue, but it's like a very yellowy green color. I like it. It's like my favorite color. Ooh. Yeah, you can see the hands. So we put, yeah, look at that. Ooh, I think I breathe in some soda ash. Yeah, it's like a very citron olive color. I love it. I'm gonna see how these look on fabric. Let's go for it.
So here we have the vinegar batch on the left and the soda ash batch on the right. I'm testing the colors with some strips of silk. You should make sure your fabric is clean and soaked. Dry fabric can streak. Most dyes require what's called a mordant to affix the color to the fabric. They can also have an effect on the hue. Here I'm using alum, which is one of the more common mordants, and I will attach some info to the video notes. You can see that when I add it to the soda ash bath, a chemical reaction occurs. I've never seen this happen before, but it's a reminder to dye outdoors or in a well-ventilated area.
So this was the vinegary one here. Ooh. Y'all, I am very into this color. I mean, once this dries, it'll be a bit lighter, but I'm really into it. It's like mauve-y. It smells kind of like pomegranate cranberry juice too, which is nice. This one looked so weird when I put the alum in. It completely bubbled up and got like slimy. I'm not sure what's going on here chemically. This was the one with soda ash, which I wouldn't think would have this sort of effect, but there's some sort of chemical reaction that happened. And it's this olive green color, which, you know, I liked it more in liquid form. I'm not sure how I like it when it washes out. It might be kind of nice, but the consistency got super weird, and I'm just wondering if there are any like longer term effects on the fabric.
So this is our dyed silk after it's been dried. This is the batch that we added vinegar to. It's kind of a mauvey berry color. And this is the batch to which we added soda ash, kind of a citron chartreuse. And I really like them both. I'm pretty surprised how different these colors are from the same original dye bath of Perilla. I was worried that this batch would have some sort of strange effects on the fabric because we had a chemical reaction with the alum mordant, but I'm not noticing a difference. They both seem a little bit stiffer than when I put them in though, so next time I might experiment with not adding alum mordant. I'm really happy that I tried this out, and I hope it inspires you to experiment with plants too. See you next time.